So generally, what do you mean by CSS? When you say CSS, cascading, style sheets. Let us go with the basic properties of CSS. First, we'll understand a few properties. Then we go for applying the CSS. First, let us see basic properties of CSS. Few properties we just open. What we do, we'll do with font. You just take a fonts. Okay, basic properties. Generally, what are the properties we have? Font color, font size, font style, font style, font size, font weight, font size, font weight, and a font family. Basically, the properties will be font size, font weight, font family, right? This will be the regular properties what we are going to use. I'll give basic format. When you are going to the applying the CSS, there are three types of CSS what we have in the library. One is inline CSS, second one is external CSS, third one is style bundle. In the component bundle, we have style. So, how many ways we can define a CSS? CSS can be applied in three ways. We can apply CSS. First one, inline. Second one, okay, component. I'll go with external first. External. Third one, component bundle. These are the three formats in which we can define. When I say internal, if you take a component, within the component, you are defining style equal to property. This is internal. Applied for the particular element. This is called inline CSS. This is called inline CSS. Now look at this. I was giving div. Style. Width 500 pixel, 50 pixel, this is what we get. So we are applying the style here. We are applying style within the component. Div style we are applying. This is called inline CSS. This is called inline CSS. Applying inline CSS. This is what we have created. So we are applying the properties for the component. At the time of creating a component itself, we are defining the properties. So this is called inline CSS. Now I am giving paragraph style. Margin, color, we are applying the properties here. So every element has its own properties. Every element has its own properties here. Every element has its own property. It is inline CSS. It is inline CSS. We are applying inline CSS, right? So we are applying the properties within the component. Let us take another example. A meaningful element I'll create. Div. So I give first element, so we got the basic structure. Now within this structure I want to redivide. Within this structure, I am creating div. Style. Width. Then float left, the same story I give. Okay. We have created two components, right? Float left, float right. We are just dividing the section. Now give borders to understand there are two different sections. One component I will create here, another component I will create here. So component 1, component 2, component 3. Dividing the row into spaces. Dividing the row into number of spaces. Right. Are you getting my point? Right. I want to create a structure. I want to create a structure. Let us go ahead with another example. Are you getting my point? My intention was to create a structure. Let us say I have intention of creating the structure like this. My intention was to create a page . This was my intention. I want to create a template in this format. When you want to create a template in this format, we are supposed to apply CSS. We are supposed to apply CSS. I want to create a template in this format, so I want to go for CSS. I will use the borders to indicate areas so that we know whether we got or not. Once you create the program, then we can remove the colors. Okay. I want to create this structure. So what I am doing, this type of partitioning is very common. Because at the end of the game, when you are designing the complete UI of your own choice, then obviously you are to supposed to manage the space what you have in the page. If you want to create the page in this format, what are the properties we are applying? So what type of CSS I am giving? I am giving inline CSS. The same inline I will modify into external down the line. I will go with the application directly. Style. This is the first element. I am creating a second element. Style. Width 200 pixel. Width 200 pixel. Height 200 pixel. Background. Green. Second one, second element we have, so I have top one, the bottom, remaining one is bottom. In the bottom again I am defining two styles. I'm just giving different background colors to indicate the space partition. When you define the elements, then you can remove the colors. Just give the partition. Now you define the elements, design the elements. Once you design, remove the colors so you know where the elements are fitting to identify our partition, right? Now what we are doing, once you create this partition, you display component one should be on the left hand side, component should be here, registration form here, detail page, that's all we can design it, right? So basically what is the purpose of this CSS? We are applying the CSS to get the look and feel, partitions and everything. The div is very, very, very commonly used property for partitioning the page. Div is very, very, very commonly used property for partitioning the page. So what type of style I have used? Inline CSS. What was this called? Inline CSS. We call it as inline CSS. I hope you are good. Right. So practice more in terms of div and splitting the pages into different structures. Okay. Let us go to the next one. My next one is how to apply external CSS. What we are doing right now is inline. If the CSS files are defined outside, how do you apply those? If the CSS files are applied outside, how do you apply those? Now let us see this. External CSS means what? We are defining CSS in the external file. Suppose I guess I defined some files here. I already made some predefined examples here. Look at this. It's okay. delayed anything. So let us look at this. No. Now we are saving this file. We define the CSS. Now you want to apply this CSS. How do you do that? Go to static resource. Go to static resource. Now I gave some files also here. Look at this, it is my CSS, one of the existing CSS outside. Okay, let me create. I just go to classic boss. See, you want to create a lighting also, you work from the classic only, do it because it's more faster. Setup. How quickly we are getting this. But lighting is faster, right? Right. This is how we create. Once we created this, what we are supposed to do? If you are going with this, we are supposed to include this resource. We are supposed to include this resource in the lighting component or lighting application. So look at the element what we have. If you want to include the static resources in the lightning component, we have lightning required. There's a element which we have lightning required. To get better understanding, let us go with the so at the time of creating a lightning component reference, we have a namespace called lightning required. Let us go to that component and understand what exactly it is. So we have lightning, URA, force, and we have what? Go to lightning. When you go to lightning required, how you are supposed to give? Resource dot resource lightning required, resource dot resource name. Resource dot resource name. Lighting require resource dot resource name. Lighting require resource dot resource name. Let us include this. Lighting require, we need to include styles equal to $s, dollar. If you want to refer to the static resource, dollar resource dot resource name. If you give it. So go to the component here. What is the resource I give? My salary. What is the style I give? One, I give one, right? Classic column. Attribute style is not found. Why attribute style is not found, boss? Styles. So go for the component styles. Now this is example. I give block gray. This is box. Now whatever the styles we applied there, I told font size 40, font weight. So whatever you are applying that file, that is included here. So if you are defining any CSS outside, if you are defining any CSS outside, if you want to include those CSS within the Lightning, store them like a static resource. Store them like a static resource, then store them like a static resource, then include them in the component or application as Lightning require styles equal to dollar resource dot resource name. If it is a single file, if it is a bundle, when I go to Bootstrap, it will be a bundle. When I go to jQuery, including a jQuery in the Lightning, it will be a bundle. When I go to including a AngularJS within the Lightning, it will be a bundle. If it is a bundle, we have a different format. If it is a single file, dollar resource dot resource name. If it is a single file, dollar resource dot resource name. I hope you are good. People are good with this. Clear? What type of CSS is this? External CSS. Now you want to apply Bootstrap. If you want to apply Bootstrap, Bootstrap is what? External CSS. Bootstrap is what? External CSS. If you want to include external CSS, then what we are doing? We are going for, like, whatever the look and feel of the Bootstrap is there, your LinkedIn look and feel is the Bootstrap look and feel, right? That if you want to include the Bootstrap in a Salesforce, like a Lightning static resource, include them like a static resource, include that file within the component as a, okay, Lightning require, then we are so going to use it. Okay, now I'll demonstrate some example. This example is clear, right? What did I do? I created a simple CSS file. I included the CSS file into the Salesforce as a static resource. Lightning required styles equal to dollar resource dot resource name. Okay. Now the point is, when you're using a Bootstrap or any other example, sir, there is a possibility of you to include elements. That may be single element, that may be multiple elements. When you are trying to include the single file, we'll give dollar resource dot js plus path amma plus path of the file. Now it is a single file, js libraries, that's all. If it is multiple files are there, remaining path. If you remember in jQuery, okay, we have done jQuery in the regular development, right? How did you define that? Do you remember that format? URL for dollar resource dot resource name slash. If I have a path like jQuery, if you have files like this, then we have used slash js slash jQuery min Do you remember this? When you have done the jQuery programs in the Visual Force, including a jQuery, we have done toggles, jQuery examples you have done. That time we have given the structure. Same story here also, boss. But here we are going to give what? Dollar source dot resource dot resource name plus this is what we are going to give. This is what we are going to give. Same thing, but it is a URL for function. Here it is not a function. That is the reason we give script equal to straight away. What is that? Resource dot resource name and remaining path of the file. Now if you want to include multiple files, then we have join file 1, file 2, file 3, file 4. Now if you remember, I don't know how many of you remember the jQuery examples. People have remembered, right? At least you know we covered the jQuery topic, right? In the development, okay. Now we'll be used to include multiple files actually. URL for dollar resource dot. Even in a streaming API integration, we have done streaming API. Do you remember the streaming API documentation? Streaming API, you remember? I guess at least you might have remembered the streaming API. I'll show the documentation if I have. It is the file I can show you. Right. So how many files we included here? These are the files. Comet D.js, jQuery 1.5.1.js, JSN.js. These four files, which we created as static resource. How did we include them? They have included straight away. They created four individual files. Otherwise, what should I do? Dump them like a zip file. And we are going to use $resource.path. Okay. Now, when you are trying to include multiple files, you have a group of files in the bundle. When you want to include multiple number of files, yeah, look at this. Now, how did I give URL for dollar jQuery? jQuery 1.8.3.js is a old file. Okay. Now we already got 11 points. Okay. Now jQuery UI 1.9.2 custom JS. How many JS files we are including? 3 files. Now if you want to include 3 files, then what we are giving? $jQuery plus file 1, comma file 2, comma file 3. How? Join file 1, comma file 2, comma file 3. If you have multiple files, instead of giving 3 individual, here we used to give include script 1, include script 1.8.3.js, include script 1.9.2 custom JS, include script 1.9.2 custom in.js. Instead of giving 3 include scripts, here we are going to use join. Join JS file 1, JS file 2, JS file 3. Are you clear about this? Followed, boss, when you are trying to include multiple files. Okay. Similarly, when you are giving a resource, here the resource can also be included in different style. This is one of the style. Second style can be resources slash name of the resource slash remaining path. So I'll give you an example here. Did you get my point? Clear? Okay. Now when you are using a jQuery to check whether jQuery files are loaded properly or not, what we used to do? To check whether jQuery files are loaded properly or not, what we used to do? we used to write the code like this to check whether jQuery files are loaded properly or not, because we are adding a JavaScript files. We want to know whether the JavaScript files are loaded properly or not. To check this, we used to write var j dollar equal to jQuery dot no config. If j dollar success, yes. If you get it, files are loaded properly. This is how we used to test the jQuery. Similarly, now we are including a bootstrap. Now we are including a JavaScript files. When you are including, how will you test whether the files are loaded properly or not? Boss, if it is an image, I will print the image. If you get the image, it is success. Image not printed, failure. If it is an image, image printed, success. Image not printed, failure. But I am going for what? JavaScript files. Until I run, I don't know whether files are running properly or not. Then how do you know whether files are loaded successfully or not? That is the reason we have after scripts loaded. After the JavaScript files what you have given, if they are loaded, then run the client side function. Run the client side function. If it is a single file, scripts equal to floor bracket hyphen dollar resource dot resource name plus path of the JS file. If it is a multiple files, script is, okay, scripts equal to okay floor bracket exclamation mark join file 1, file 2, file 3, so on. So how do you test it? After the script loaded, perform this client side action. There I'll print success or failure. Is this was clear? So lightning required. It is used to include CSS, external CSS or external JavaScript files. If you want to include external JavaScript files or external script files within the lightning component, we are going to use lightning required. First, whatever the external CSS you want to use, whatever the external JavaScript you want to use, they have to be loaded into Salesforce as a static resource. Whatever the external JavaScript you want to use, whatever the external CSS files you want to use, load them into the Salesforce as static resource. Then include those static resource into the component using the lightning required. Now it will ask you single file or multiple files. Okay, this is my requirement. So I'll try to show an example now how to work with the bootstrap. How to work with the bootstrap? I already downloaded here bootstrap file, bootstrap 3.3.7 distribution file. Now the fourth version also came, but I already have a file, I'm using it. I don't want to download and do all the stuff. So already I'm having a bootstrap 3.3.7. This bootstrap file I'm going to use. How will you use this? Go to, I don't want this. Setup, build, create, we have develop, static resource. I already included the static resource here. What was the static resource? Satish. Now this is your zip file. I already uploaded the boot files to check out whether it's compatible or not. Already uploaded the files. Now the file is available to you in the form of what? Now I also included one jQuery file because I require jQuery also for performing some functionality. So already I have a jQuery file. This jQuery file uploaded. This bootstrap file uploaded. I already uploaded to check the compatibility of this version with the Lightning. They are working. So I already created. I have done one or two examples before explaining. So I already uploaded them as a static resource. What is the name of the resource? Satish. What is the name of the resource? jQuery. Now if you go to static resource, bootstrap, CSS, in the CSS we have bootstrap, min.css, bootstrap, all these are what? CSS file. Okay. Now look at the first example. I'll share this document with you. By looking at this, you'll follow because already we explained the points. Look at the point. first we are supposed to include. How do you include? Lightning required. If you find any difficulty in understanding, I will discuss. Otherwise, you can look at this one. Now, what is the file we want to use? Bootstrap min.css. I told you there are two formats of including the styles. One is lightning dot dollar resource dot resource dot resource name dollar dollar resource dot resource name. Or else go to Satish. How are you finding it? So download action. Now when you open this, resources slash Satish. The URL is going to be what? Resources dot slash Satish. Resource slash Satish. After Satish, what is there? After Satish, Bootstrap distribution. In the Bootstrap distribution, CSS. In the CSS, we have Bootstrap dot. Right. That's what I have given here. Bootstrap distribution, CSS, Bootstrap, min dot CSS. This is one format. What is the other format we have? Other format I have. Styles equal to. Because already I have done that example, I am taking this type of form of example. Either that format or this format, anyone I can use. Dollar resource dot resource name, remaining path plus remaining path, or else resource slash Satish slash path of the file. Now here, look at the point. I am including Bootstrap JavaScript as well as Bootstrap JavaScript, and I am including jQuery. Two files I am including. One is the jQuery file of, one is jQuery I am including, other one is Bootstrap. Another one is Bootstrap. Look at the file. In this, we have CSS one part. We also have JavaScript. In the JavaScript, you are taking Bootstrap, min. Are you getting? So, how many scripts you want to include? One jQuery you want to include? You want to include one jQuery? You want to include one jQuery? Bootstrap. So, if you want to include multiple files, what we should give? Scripts. The purpose of taking the jQuery, intentionally I have taken the file to show you the two scriptings we are including. Actually, I am not using anything in the program for jQuery. Only to tell you that multiple files we can include, I have taken this. So what I have given? Bootstrap scripts join resource one. This is a single file, dollar resource dot resource name. It is a zip file. In the zip file, we have that. So dollar resource dot resource name plus path. After scripts loaded, after the script is loaded, I want to check whether the file is loaded properly or not. So I can give console.log. Have a preview. I am not printing anything. Just I want to check. Script loaded successfully. So this is how external scripts and external pages we are including in the lightning. Okay. You are included, very good. Now my example is, I want to go for using LIs, navigation tabs. So look at this. Now, whatever we are finding in the lightning design system, similar format will be there in the Bootstrap also. Lightning design system, whatever the BEM model is there, same will be available here. So what I'm going to do here, I'll close off this. I'll open here Bootstrap navigation bar. Already the WT also we have. Okay. What we have? Navigation bar. I want menu, navigation menu. Home, page, page 2, page 3. Like this we want. If you want this, they told navbar default. What is the format they give? Nav navigation bar, right? Then list. UL is what? Unorder list. Okay, OL is what? Order list. LI is list item. When I click on this, which is the page should open? A is anchor. When I click on this, which page has to open? A, reference hash page 1. Are you getting my point? Now what was this style? Class equal to nav. So I am going to take this, copy this code. What is the class, CSS class we have? Nav, navigation, navbar navigation. Go to this. Basically, unordered list, list item 1, list item 2, list item 3, list item 4. The look and feel of lightning we are getting. Look and feel of lightning we are getting, right? Sorry, look and feel of bootstrap. Right, who gave this color? Who gave that color? Who gave the width of the box? That is already defined in the CSS of nav. So whatever the CSS of nav is applied, the same thing we are applying here. Is that was clear? If you want to get the menu bar with the look and feel of this, instead of you learning it, go to the bootstrap. Already predefined structures are there. Use those structures. Instead of you defining everything, already predefined structures are there. Use that. I hope you are good with this. I hope you are good with this. Right, Amma? Clear for everyone? Clear? So who defined this CSS? External CSS. It is not my CSS. This CSS is defined in this. The name of the class, what is the class? Nav, navbar navigation. Who defined this? It is available here. We are including the bootstrap from external system into Salesforce. We are trying to apply those things on the component. I hope you are good. Okay. Similarly, let us go to the next example. Now, we'll try to apply buttons. This is the grid basics. Try to understand this. Now, we have a row. Look at the point. Look at the point. So, what is the size? 4, 4, 4. They divided. They divide the row into number of columns. Now, columns 4. 1, 2, 3. They divided equal size. Column they have divided into equal size. Column they have divided into equal size. Column they have divided into equal size. How they are defining? Let me give you this. Did you get my point? So this same is available to us in the lightning design system also, boss. Let me give you that. I told you bootstrap is almost, lightning design system is almost similar to bootstrap. Now look at this four. They divide into 1, 2, 3, 4. So what do they give? Div class, SLDS grid, SLDS getters, 4 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next one. They want to divide into 12 columns. Now they give SLDS grid, 12 columns. Now, one column they have to occupy, they told. One total number of columns, 3. In 3, first column want to occupy 2 out of 3. Second column want to occupy 1 out of 3. So what are they giving? SLDS size 2 of 3. SLDS size 1 of 3. So already it is what? It is lightning design system. You can use the same structure. You can use the same structure, or else you can go with the, your bootstrap. The bootstrap also is almost same. What was this? Look at this. Columns. I will go with another example to show you this. Probably. So look at this. Now they are giving 12 columns. Now this is what? 4, 4, 4. So what should they give? 4 of 12, 4 of 12, 4 of 12. They should give 4 of 12, 8 of 12. They should give 6 of 12, 6 of 12. They should give row. Are you getting my point? Are you getting my point here? Right? So, whatever the structure they are giving here, whatever the structure they are giving here, almost it is similar to your bootstrap. But bootstrap lighting design system almost similar. But only here they are using a bootstrap naming convention, here they are using SLDS. There is only difference. Here we have, look at the system, we have Kohl's SM4. Here they are using SLDS grid, grid SLDS grid. Now either you use this or go this. If you are familiar with this, you can go. If you go with the bootstrap, in the future, if any other technology you are learning also, it will be helpful to you. Now, doesn't mean that this SLDS cannot be used with other technology. I told you, lighting design system can also be used with other technology. Whichever you feel comfort, you can use it. Are you getting my point? Are you clear about this? So what they are doing? Dividing the data into grids. Dividing the data into grids. Okay. Next we have floats. What was that? Float left, float right, float right, SLDS float right, class. Float right, none, clear fix, none, clear fix, both the sides. Right. So what was this? What was this? What was this? SLDS float none, SLDS float right, SLDS float, floating the data in the box. Now I gave class there, right? What I gave? Float left, float right. Instead of that, you can go with SLDS float left, SLDS float right. So what we can do, I'll get this structure. This is built in, force colon SLDS built in. If you want to use a bootstrap, we have to include and apply. If you want to use a bootstrap, you have to include and apply. This is built in. So what I can do here, I can give here now, why you are getting one after the other? Because you never mentioned size of this. You never mentioned the size of this. If you mention the size of the div, only mention the size of the inner element, we'll get it. If we never mention the size of the outer element, how the data will be aligned? The data will not be aligned. You need to apply the style. You need to mention the size. How you mention the size? Then I have to go for, again, style class or inline. I have to go for a style class or inline. Straight away, if I apply, I am not getting. Why? The div size should be given. If you don't mention the div size, how the data will be aligned? Width and height, if you give me, I will say go to left or go to right. Are you getting my point? So, boss, it is simply your patience. If you have good patience, go through one by one CSS, go through it, keep practicing. If you don't have patience, as per the requirement, go check out the element. Copy paste it, change the names, get the look and feel. You want to prove your worth? Take one by one element, start practicing. Okay, as simple as that. Now let us go to the next. I want to go to the buttons. If you want to go to the buttons, how do you apply the buttons here? Anything? Yeah. Buttons. So already we got this type of variants, right? Variant success, variant danger, warning. Same story. Here also what we have? Button, button default. Primary, success, info, warning, danger. So what is the data we have? Copy this. We are going for a buttons. If you want to apply the buttons, what is the primary thing we have to do, boss? First include bootstrap. I hope you have followed this already. I'm just copy pasting it. assuming that you already followed, I'm copy pasting it, right? Look and feel of the buttons. Okay. Now, only the point is, instead of you applying your own thoughts with align left, right, instead of doing this, go to the existing CSS, already look and feel will come. Okay, you know how the look and feel will be, the copy paste the code, get the similar look. That is the advantage of going for Lightning Design System or going for a bootstrap. Otherwise, what should I do? If I want to get this structure, the style, I have to apply a lot of size, background color, color, width, radius, border, margin, all this stuff. Instead of that, what I am doing? Already existing style was there, copy paste and we get it. You got the similar look. Okay. I hope you are good. Okay. Next, we'll apply model box was there. Drop downs, the objects. Drop downs will go with. What was the drop down? Drop down menu. We want to get a drop down menu. So which is easier? Applying your own CSS easier or copy pasting is easier? Right? So whichever you feel comfortable, you do that. Just or button is, until you include the bootstrap correctly into the program is a button. Once you are done, we can replicate the code. This is how we are getting the button. Then we allow, right, we can even go for this. Data table already we have done it now. Data table is not with this CSS. Data table is what? We are not done with this. Data table is a lightning colon data table. That is a different structure. It is not with the CSS. It is with the rows and the number of fields. We have done an example with the rows and number of fields. That is a different story again. Okay, somebody is asking. Okay, come back to this. Okay, table you are asked, right? So let me give. What is the table? Maybe pagination. Tables are there. So which structure you want? So look at the structure, what you need, just copy paste it and you align the data, then you can align the data, how do you can make a dynamic, how to keep a loops, that we can do it. This is only to get the look and feel. Conceptually whatever you want to do, you have to do it in the same way. What was that? Class table. Success, danger, info, warning, active. They again multiple properties. Issue was I wrote a scripting functionality actually. Scripting is not done. The different structures I have given, you decide how, what is the structure you want. Okay. Right now, this is the table they have given. What you can make? What you can make? You can write era iteration. You can write era iteration. Get this table instead of TR, TD, these things. You can get with the era iteration. Every TR we can get with the era iteration. Style will be the structure. Now you want to apply success or a danger or info, apply any style and use your iteration, the table structure will come. It is a loop, right? Did you get my point? Did you get or not? Okay, how do you create a group of records? Your iteration is there. In the iteration, what we are going to give? TR. TR, TD, TD, TD. In the TR class equal to danger. Or class equal to info. Then whatever the data we are getting, instead of you manually writing the number of rows, whatever the list of records we got, that we are going to display it. Then what else we can try? Just see, boss. The issue is, go to the bootstrap, check out what are there, how the look and feels are there. As per that, just click, you get a code. Now you understand how this code can be used in the writing to get the structure. Now these are, they are going to manually give the data. Now you need to understand how programmatically you can insert the data into that location. Remaining structure will be the same. That's how we can simplify the writing of programming. Right? I hope you are good. Clear? Okay. So basically, our intention was how to use Bootstrap. So how do you include the Bootstrap in the, how do you include the Bootstrap here? Create a static resource, include them in the static resource, include them in the component or application as Lightning require styles and script. Then start creating your component and applying the CSS. So that is including external CSS within the, applying external CSS within the Lightning component, right? One example external CSS I have taken is a Bootstrap. I hope you are good, right? You just go through the components and find out what styles are there. Just a copy paste of the code, nothing else you have to do. I hope you are good. Clear? Okay. Next one. Okay. Next one is the major part. Applying the style and how do you apply different styles? How to apply the styles for outer elements, inner elements, sub elements? Is a different structure. Okay. Let us take 5 minutes break and come. We'll continue. That is important. Probably that will take around 15 minutes. Then I'll go to the flows. Okay. Just 5 minutes break. Let us take it.